open my Gangster Pink H&K G36C airsoft rifle. First gun. So I'm pretty fucking excited. I've been waiting about a week for this bad boy now. Just got into it, and I figured what better way than to go with the most toxic character in any video game I've ever played, assault rifle, Ash, with her G36C. Now already, I'm liking this box. Very simple, clean, H&K Heckler & Koch. This is what we're in store for, bad boys. Nothing quite as gangster as a pink gun.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. Oh, this is everything that I needed in life. Here's the manual. Save the best part for last. So here's the battery, little spicy boy. Heavy duty too. That must have some life to it, huh? Here's the charger. Probably gonna have to use this until I get a smart charger. Everything that I've seen and read said to get one, because, well, with anything, if you charge it more than it needs to be charged, it will kill the battery and it just won't work anymore, you know. So I'll just have to, you know, keep a watchful eye on it. Kind of just, you know, see where it goes. Now, here's the best part. Has a foldable stock.
This thing's got some weight to it.
It's a pretty nice, it's a pretty satisfying weight. See what this looks like with the stock out. As soon as I figure out how to do that, I don't want to break it. There we go. This is the G36C by H&K. I got it for $150. Got it down to $130. It was on sale after being $220 originally. Yeah, and I believe, from what I've seen online, this is the hop up. It's still new. My friends are probably gonna laugh at me, but you know, they don't have a pink gun, so fuck them. They'll never be this gangster. Now, obviously, I'm gonna have to get a rail because my iron sight aiming is pretty shit. See here. Okay. This looks like a mid-cap magazine. Pretty goddamn hyped. I won't lie. I have the only thing left in this room. I don't have to figure out how to load this bad boy. Which looks like I just kind of do that. And that feeds through here. That's what it looks like without the clip. Pretty standard stuff. Nothing too crazy. But, you know, when I come in on that CQB arena, slapping some bitches with this fucking just nasty pink bad boy, they ain't gonna see it coming. I guess. guess we should read the instruction manual, huh? This bad boy right here. Forgot how to slap that battery in there. Oh. For the obvious note, this is your fire selector. Semi-auto. Single fire. Semi-auto. And safety. See, can't pull it. So I put on that. And then, I'm not gonna lie, I kinda feel like I'm gonna break it just pressing this trigger. Otherwise, it has a pretty nice feel to it. It's very, like, not hyper real, obviously, but it's got weight, and that's what I wanted in a gun. When I was looking online at it, I was afraid that maybe it would be a little too plasticky and, you know, not weigh as much. But it feels pretty good, I'm not gonna lie. Feels pretty good. Alright, let's see here. Installing rechargeable battery. When batteries have almost lost their charge, they can cause gearbox malfunctions that require repair. Batteries should never be overcharged. This can damage the cell. Prolonged overcharging causes permanent damage to batteries. Batteries should always be fully drained before charging. There's no warranty for batteries. Use only those batteries of minimum 9.6 volt, 3000 megahertz. To remove this pin somehow, and I have a weird feeling I need a tool for that. Oh, no I don't. It just pops right the fuck out. Okay. Remove the forend. This is what it looks like without the barrel on it. Pretty standard stuff, I'm assuming. Okay, connect the plug. So it clicks like that. Mm-hmm. Mount the battery. However the fuck that means. Does one mount the battery? You just kind of just fucking hold it there. Slide on the forend. Do not crush the cables.